Want to learn. Today we are going to discuss briefly about a fair filters with windowing technique. Let's try to recall the relation between analog frequencies and the concerned digital frequencies. Consider a continuous time signal as follows: a cos 2 pi ft plus pi, and let fs be the sampling rate. Fs equals to 1 by Ts, right? Where Ts is the sampling period and Fs is the sampling rate. Ts is the sampling interval. To try to sample this uniformly at an interval of Ts, we are going to get x of nts equals to a cos 2 pi f nts plus pi, replacing T with nts, where Ts can be replaced with 1 by Fs. And this can be represented in the digital format with this notation: a cos omega n plus pi, where this omega is digital frequency, which is in radians per sample. Omega equals to 2 pi f by fs, where f is the concerned analog signal frequency, fs is the sampling rate we are using for this. According to baseband sampling theorem, highest frequency of the message signal, this f should be equals to fs by 2. F should be less than or equals to fs by 2, where fs is the sampling rate. So the highest possible frequency, f equals to fs by 2, this is the analog frequency. The concerned digital frequency will be pi radians per sample. If you want, you can substitute this one. If you replace f with fs by 2 into this expression, then we are going to get omega equals to pi, which is the highest possible digital frequency. Because if you go beyond f greater, beyond fs by 2, there will be aliasing effect, right? That's why you need to bound up to fs by 2. And this digital frequency will be periodic with a period of 2 pi, right? This we have seen earlier. And you can find high frequencies nearby odd multiple of pi and low frequencies nearby even multiple of pi, including 0, right? Including omega equal to 0. So it's enough for us to represent DTFT within this 2 pi interval, minus pi to pi interval. This is covering 2 pi interval, right? Due to periodicity. Indirectly, this pi corresponds to fs by 2. This minus pi corresponds to minus fs by 2. This is a frequency response of all pass filter or all pass system. We are just bothering about minus pi to pi interval, right? Because this is repetitive. For every 2 pi interval, this will repeat this pattern. It's a periodic pattern. H alpha of e power j omega, which is equals to 1 for all omega. And if you go beyond pi also, this always equals to 1. But no need to bother about this one. We'll just try to consider minus pi to pi interval. This is not attenuating any frequency. This is always providing equal gain for all frequency components. This is alpha system. And this is the ideal low pass filter. In the pass band, gain should be 1. In the stop band, gain should be 0. If you consider this one, just consider this pi to frequency components only, 0 to pi interval. Because by default, this is symmetric in nature, right? This side. You can consider only from 0 to pi interval. This is more than enough. You can see within this interval, 0 to omega c interval, the gain is 1 in the pass band. And after omega c, the gain is 0, right? Omega c to pi interval, the gain is 0. Indirectly, the same thing will happen for analog frequencies, right? The constant thing, the constant effect. You can try to map digital frequency omega to analog frequency f, omega equals to 2 pi f by fs. the concerned mapping in there, right? To do something for this omega c, the concerned f will be affected in the analog domain indirectly. And this is a high pass system with cutoff frequency of omega c hp. So high pass filter cutoff frequency 0 to omega c hp interval, the gain is 0. This is a stop band, and this is a pass band omega c hp to pi, the gain is equals to 1. And this is a band pass system. Here the pass band is from omega p1 to omega p2. Between omega p1 and omega p2, the gain is 1. In the stop band, there are two stop bands here, right? In these two stop bands, the gain is 0. It's an ideal band pass filter. And the center frequency of this pass band is omega p1 plus omega p2 by 2. We are representing this with notation omega naught. And the gap between the center frequency and this one is omega p2 minus omega p1 by 2. You can see this gap. This total thing corresponds to omega p2 minus omega p1, this gap. This part corresponds to divide by 2, right? Omega p2 minus omega p1 divided by 2. And this is the ideal band stop system. Ideal band stop filter. There is a stop band from omega s1 to omega s2. The gain is 0 in this band. The remaining band, the gain is equal to 1. Just look into 0 to pi interval. By default, this is symmetric in nature. If you flip this one, we are going to get this. And after that, this is periodic with period 2 pi. You can repeat this pattern. You know this one, that's more than enough, right? 0 to pi interval. Let's have a look into ideal low pass filter. The gain is equal to 1 in the pass band and the gain equal to 0 in the stop band. Here omega c is the cutoff frequency. And the concerned impulse response will be sin omega cn by pi n. And you can see clearly that this is not a causal system because this h of n is not equal to 0 for n less than 0. So you can say this is non-causal system. Non-causal means we can't implement that practically in the real time, right? If you can't implement this in the real time, we should try to convert this into a causal system. And this is an IAR system, infinite impulse response system. Because you can see, this will go till n equals to infinity, and that side that will go till n equals to minus infinity, right? The length of this one is infinity, the duration. That's why we are calling it like IAR system. We will use windowing to make it as FIR system. We will try to apply some window. Let's have a look into that. For that, let's try to revise this frequency shifting property of DTFT. Let's have h of n, h of e power j omega, here the phase, DTFT phase. And if you try to multiply this with complex exponential, h of n into e power j omega naught n implies h of e power j into omega minus omega naught. This is frequency shifted right side by omega naught units. And again here this one, 2 cos omega naught n into h of n. This can be written like, cos can be written like e power j omega naught n plus e power minus j omega naught n divided by 2. And this 2 gets cancelled out and we are getting this one. And the DTFT for this will be h of e power j into omega minus omega naught plus h of e power j into omega plus omega naught. This is right shift by omega naught units. This is left shift by omega naught units. And don't forget that h of e plus omega is periodic with a period of 2 pi. That's by default that will come. Periodicity. Okay, if you consider omega naught from 0 to pi interval only, then e power j omega naught n is a real sequence only for omega naught equals to pi. You can cross check this one. When omega naught equals to pi, this e power j pi n, which is same as minus 1 whole power n, then only the sequence will be real. For all other values of omega naught in this interval, it's a complex number or complex sequence. So, in order to get real impulse response after frequency shifting, we will multiply h of n with 2 cos omega naught n instead of multiplying with e power j omega naught n. Because I want to have real h of n. I don't want that complex h of n. I want to have h of n to be a real sequence. For that, I'll try to multiply with some other real sequence, 2 cos omega naught n. For example, if someone gave you the impulse response for the low pass filter, some small h low pass of n, someone gave you this one, and they ask you to find high pass filter with the help of this one, you can simply go for frequency shifting operation. For example, if you try to multiply this one with e power j pi n, h low pass of n into e power j pi n, then we need to shift this right side by pi units, right? If we shift this right side by pi units, this 0 will be shifted to pi, minus omega c will be shifted to pi minus omega c will be shifted to pi plus omega c. Then we are going to get a high pass system like this, right? High pass filter. It's a high pass filter with a cutoff frequency of pi minus omega c. Because this lowest frequency here is pi minus omega c, right? Similarly, if someone wants a band pass system with the help of this one, then we can simply multiply h low pass of n with 2 cos omega naught n. Once you do that operation, we are going to get right shift by omega naught units and left shift by omega naught units, right? Then this will be shifted to omega naught, and this will be shifted to omega naught minus omega c. This will be omega naught plus omega c. That means you are going to get some band pass system like this. Similarly, if you do left shift by omega naught, we are going to get somewhere here, right? Still that symmetry maintained. This reflection will be there, right? This side. It means if we know the impulse response for low pass filter, with the help of that one, we can try to design band pass filter, or you can try to design high pass filter, or if you want, you can design band stop filter also. Think about band stop filter, how to design that one. Ideal low pass to ideal high pass filter transformation. Okay, if you do this operation, h high pass of n equals minus 1 whole power n h low pass of n, then what's going to happen is this will be shifted right side by pi units. 0 will be shifted to pi, right? We have seen that figure. Frequency shifting property. This one is same as high pass filter with a cutoff frequency of pi minus omega c. Because minus omega c will be shifted to pi minus omega c, right? which is the lowest frequency in that pass band. So if you want high pass filter with the cutoff frequency of omega cp, then we need to design low pass filter with the cutoff frequency of omega c equals to pi minus omega c hp. Then if you try to shift this right side by pi units, we are going to end up with high pass filter with the cutoff frequency of omega c hp. Let's look into this figure once again. We need to consider pi minus omega c hp and this is minus of pi minus omega c hp. Now if you try to shift this right side by pi units after that frequency shifting operation, then this will become like pi minus of pi minus omega c hp. That pi gets cancelled out and we are going to end up with omega c hp. This frequency will be shifted to omega c hp. Ideal low pass to ideal band pass transformation. And if you try to multiply H low pass fn with 2 cos omega naught n, then we are going to get shifting of this in the frequency domain, right side by omega naught units, left side by omega naught units. Suppose omega p1 and omega p2 be the pass band cutoff frequencies for band pass filter, then we need omega naught equals to omega p1 plus omega p2 by 2 and omega c equals to omega p2 minus omega p1 by 2. Let's say I look into that figure. We need omega c equals to omega p2 minus omega p1 by 2, right? What we are expecting is this interval should be exactly same as this interval. So if you try to, this interval, right? If you try to shift that one right side by omega naught units, then you are going to end up with this exactly, right? That's the reason we are expecting this interval means omega p2 minus omega p1. This should be equal to this interval. This interval is same as 2 omega c. 2 omega c equals to omega p2 minus omega p1 implies omega c equals to omega p2 minus omega p1 divided by 2, right? And omega naught should be the center frequency of them, right? Center frequency of them means that should be omega p1 plus omega p2 by 2. Then only that 0 will be shifted to omega naught, right? Here that 0 is shifting to omega naught. We are shifting 0 to omega naught. Ideal low pass to ideal band stop filter transformation. In order to design band stop filter with stop band cutoff frequencies omega s1 and omega s2, first we'll try to design band pass filter with pass band cutoff frequencies omega p1 equals to omega s1 and omega p2 equals to omega s2. After that, we'll simply subtract from alpha system. Then we are going to end up with band stop filter. And we know how to design band pass filter with the help of low pass filter, right? You can have a look into this one. Alpha system in this equals to 1 for all omega. If you try to subtract this particular system with alpha system, this one gets cancelled out. You are going to get stop band here. If omega s1 equals omega p1 and omega s2 equals omega p2, this one gets nullified and the remaining part 1 minus 0 is 1, right? 1 minus 0 is 1. In this part, 1 minus 1 is 0. We are going to end up with band stop system, right? And this delta of n is the inverse DTFT for this one. This is alpha system. 1 means alpha system. For all omega, this equals to 1. Alpha means band pass. Similarly, you can try to convert ideal low pass to ideal high pass system with the help of all pass filter. You can have a look into this. Thank you.